Hey guys, Coach Sue here with Physique Development, and I recently had a client that was struggling with digestion, and we really wanted to nail down things without including supplements. So I wanted to be able to explain that to you about some things that you can put in place and really improve digestion, things I've done myself to improve digestion without adding other things to the mix. Now, of course, supplements can come into play, but we want to focus on nailing down some of these things first. One is going to be protein distribution and macro distribution in general. Each person has their own kind of threshold digestion-wise in regards to what feels best for them. So for me, eating 50 grams of protein is kind of my threshold in regards to how my digestion feels. For fat, that's probably going to be around 15 grams per meal. For carbs, it can be all the way up to like 85 grams, but past that, I can see some adverse reactions there. So figuring out what that macro allotment looks like for you, and also having even distribution throughout the day can also be very beneficial to make sure that you're good to go. Another thing is going to be meal timing, making sure you're timing them in the place that you're not rushed when you're eating meals. And that's another big thing, is making sure you're not stressed or rushed while you're eating meals. When you're stressed, your body is very smart, but it also looks at stress as like, hey, I'm trying to do something other than eat food right now. And so oftentimes it can mess up your digestion because it's focusing on other processes in your body. So making sure that you take a few deep breaths, you de-stress, you make sure you take time to eat your food, making sure you thoroughly chew your food. Digestion starts in the mouth with your saliva, so making sure you thoroughly chew your food. I used to have a really bad habit of just scarfing down my food and swallowing it before it's fully chewed. So making sure you're fully chewing your food. Low stress environment, making sure you're eating your food slowly is going to be absolutely huge. And then also post-workout, if you're finding you're having upset stomach post-workout, waiting until your heart rate goes into a few beats within resting heart rate before you eat, especially if you're doing something high intensity and your heart rate is up very, very high and you try to eat food, it's not gonna be the most optimal for digestion. Getting in your water intake is gonna be huge, but if you're noticing that you're having problems with water as you eat your meals, decreasing that water during while you're eating your meal. So still hitting your water goal for the day. And if you want to learn more about hitting your water goal, you can check out our video on that. But it is something that sometimes too much water while you're eating can wash away some of those digestive juices and make it a little bit more difficult for your body to digest that food. So you want to hit your water goal, but if you're noticing too much bloating around your eating, making sure that you're lowering that water volume during your meal time. Another thing is gonna be fiber. And this is also gonna be something that we wanna look at, fiber allotment and distribution. So maybe you're hitting your fiber goal per day. And when we look at fiber, the recommended daily amount is gonna be 10 to 14 grams per 1,000 calories. But remember, that is a guideline and you need to figure out what's best for you. But figuring out how much fiber is too much fiber in one sitting. So for me, much past 10 grams in one sitting is pretty hard for me. So being able to stay under that 10 gram time per meal is huge for me and being able to make sure my digestion stays on track. So distributing that throughout the day and putting yourself in the absolute best spot there. Another great thing is going for a 5 to 10 minute walk after your meals to make sure everything's moving or grooving. Nothing too strenuous. You're not trying to go for a run or do anything high intensity. Just get your body moving. Another beneficial thing in terms of exercise is being able to do yoga or some certain yoga moves are really beneficial for your digestive tract. So those are just a few things that you can do to really help your digestion, but also optimizing stress, nailing down your sleep, because sleep can affect not only digestion, but also it can affect weight gain down the road. Being able to make sure that you get your water in, get your fiber in, all of those things are going to be extremely, extremely helpful when it comes to distributing your meals and making sure you nail down your digestion. The last thing I'll mention is if you're still having problems with digestion, it could be something that you're eating. So being able to keep a food log, take inventory of how you feel after certain meals. If you feel gurgling, if you feel bloated, if you feel off, being able to revert instead of making it extremely restrictive, go to something like a low FODMAP diet, which is going to take away a lot of the highly either acidic things or things that are going to cause distress within your stomach. And you can always add those things back in, but it's a somewhat of elimination diet, but it's going to be something that there's not high irritants or agitation within those foods. And something I realized with one client in particular was garlic is something that's pretty high FODMAP, and a lot of her meals and seasonings were including garlic. So it was something that once we took garlic out of the mix, she was good to go and she did didn't realize as much irritation. So really being able to take inventory, pay attention to what your body is telling you. Your body is smart and it does speak to you. So being able to take inventory of that will put you in an absolutely great spot for your digestion. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any other questions or want to check out any other videos, give us a look at physiquedevelopment.com.